And that ends on the 8th. Well, I hope it's not. It's, they can stop me from playing the game. Because you shouldn't be raging during the game. Yep, definitely a consideration every time I play football. Difference in play in their opinion of it.
What he had, ended up winning two national championships as a starting quarterback at North Dakota State.
Play fake to Blunt. Now it's Wentz. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Torn back across his body. Picked off at the 28. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
Brandon, when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach and talked about how they wanted to begin this game offensively, they talked about their script, didn't they? 10 to 15 plays, the first 10 to 15 they had on their script. Nowhere on the script was there throwing an interception, I have to believe.
Now this offense about ready to take over again. They'll start this drive with very good field position. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Flush to his right. And he's got room. Got the ball downfield and keeps it himself for 11 on the first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation.
Asphalt Jungle, you can't get that same result on that.
Yeah. Why?
Because of your person.
Himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks and picked up the first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him to the 2nd and 3.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through. Pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably trailing on the end zone right now, so we got it going, boys. Let's keep it going.
And here he'll get it down to this.
Yeah, it was down.
Yeah. 7. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down. Well, let's give some credit to the defense. They did a nice job there as they flushed him to his right. But he is able to buy some time.
The O-line track is what I just watched. So that is right where we need to do. Let's try the win. Yep. But you don't need two of them, so you can get rid of the O-line trap.
Taking it in from 7 yards away. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead.
I didn't think that far ahead.
Just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result? 6 points.
Touchdown. Justin Tucker for the extra point. It's up and good, and it'll give his guys a 7-0 lead. So that drive of 4 plays, and in the end, it's capped off by a 7-yard run. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And last time was a pretty one-pointed interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Get the quarterback some confidence.
Try to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack.
Well, it's got less stats than on the right end, but he still hit 93 speed. Damn it.
I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
Out of position right in Bo Jackson.
Together here from the D-line. Now a first carry for LeGarrette Blount. A nice move gets him a few extra. Down just shy of his 20. They get 6 yards back on the run, but still have a third and long situation forthcoming.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game.
Let's go here.
Situation on fourth.
One thing I love about this game is there's a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? I feel like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call, but unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
And before the punt, time is going to run out on this first quarter. 7-0 is our score, and we're back to Philadelphia after this.
Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you, you're ugly. Snickers satisfies.
Back live with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaughton. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number 2, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. So on fourth down, here's the veteran left-footed punter Donnie Jones to kick it away. Mm-hmm. Fielded at the 43. Might have been one man away from 6 points. As it stands, it's a huge return. And this is going to set up a first and goal from the 5. Heading back out there. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they will. Big doggy road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right?
And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Michael Vick, a 5-yard touchdown run. And his guys are going to add on to their lead.
Okay.
And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments. Let him run it in. They did it.
Oh, wide receiver, Vic. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Or quarterback.
Result, yeah.
Tap back, that's right.
Now Tucker to add the PAT. And it's good to make it 14-0. A nice, tidy little drive there, getting the ball in excellent field position. And only one play to score. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback.
Okay. Got a 2.
Philadelphia getting set to take the field. This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't got a first down yet in this game.
It's a myth.
Let's try again.
Yeah.
All right, good. Now, here. And there. Let's see here. A bit of this homework to do. And other homework to do. Let's do tomorrow. I think like at midnight. Yes, she can. They will group anything. That means. I guess they would have to. I don't think so.
until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. The drive starts with a handoff to Blunt. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Wentz to throw on second down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And Blount loses the football. And the defense will get their hands on it.
And I guess we'll go back to this.
You look at the guy who caught it up and say, geez, what did he do? Let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, but man, I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations, big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play as we have reached the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this.
Well, you probably understood.
It's halftime. Remember, we'll get you out to Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of this first half. That is, of course, unless you decide to skip him.
And for the record, we do not encourage that.
Second and goal as the offense looks to try to punch it in. And a little bit of space there, takes it inside the 5 to 3. Give it right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on 3rd and goal. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that 2nd down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4 down territory.
Yeah, there's a bunch.
And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. And Tucker's kick right there, it's good. And the lead will grow, it's now 17-0. So they recover the fumble but could not take advantage of the short field. They do get 3.
And no one ever turns down 3 points going up on the board, but the offense will go to the sidelines wondering what if, while the defense on the other side, they'll celebrate holding them in just a field goal after giving up such bad field position.
Now LeGarrette Blount gets set to go again on offense. And for him, it's been pretty limited involvement down on the scoreboard. Maybe time to turn to this guy.
And you know me well. Winning games to me means starting with the running game and continuing to press the running game. Maybe you go away from him a little bit now, but the bottom line is he hasn't touched it enough to make a difference.
They haven't established that running game yet, but motion is well there. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up 2nd down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and this shows on the screen.
And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. And 2 Tall Jones in there to get him for a loss of 5. On 3rd and long, it's Wentz. And that is incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. But that's a big miss. Here is the punter, Jones, as he gets this one away. And it's fielded at the 34. Wow, ovation aggressive. Make a miss. Nice job on the return.
You really need to move your blocks up there.
Yes.
Scary. It's very scary.
This offensive unit is going to get set to take over here. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point kicker. Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help you with contract time. And that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know about the contract time. You can take that one too. He's got his man short, complete, and he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, 22.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's what really pays off: able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
And they'll send the tight end in motion here. They'll look to throw down, first down. Throwing left side, he's got clock complete.
Clock truck.
We've hit halftime, two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
All right, Brandon, back to you guys in a minute. But first, it's indeed time for our EA Sports halftime report. The Eagles haven't played their best football and trail because of it. The Ultimates will want to come out after the half and really put the pressure on from the start. Take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. After the INT, offense comes out now. He's got it on the run, and a quick three-play drive ends with the score as they get out to a 7-0 lead. Ultimates on first and five. Vic's going to hit outside to the right, and this run goes for a touchdown. The lead now at 14.
Back, Charles and I settle in the booth ready for quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the six. And we'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
Just seeing people out, so it makes me real.
So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They built a good first half lead, now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he takes this one just shy of midfield on the way to the 49. No one there to help out downfield, but no problem. Scrambling for 22 and a first.
On that play, as you saw the route start to develop downfield, I got the sense that maybe the run would set up for him. And he took full advantage of it and got a big gain on a busted play.
First throw now for the backup Lance. Throw a sound complete. That's good. And he'll get it down here to the 43. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first half completion.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the track route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll look to throw here. Good for 15 and a first.
Offensively, they like their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open. So it was tucking in run time, and he picks up a first down.
Back to throw now, first down. Flushed out right. And an alley to run. And he'll avoid the tackle.
Okay, that combo was wrong.
Gets him six, and it'll be second down. Well, he's proved to be real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can. And that's what he's done very well in this game. On the ground, this is Jackson. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step.
Let's go!
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's right. Sorry.
And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. As we are set to bring you the home stretch.
Not wearing my
mask.
It's more
nice
than wearing it.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Yep. Upset that. And that's a broken controller. Mm-hmm. All stacked at that.
Looking to throw. Nine timers left. Looking for Clark. He's got it complete. And he'll be out of bounds. And looking for on third down, and that sets up the first and goal.
When you have someone doing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
And you don't have to tuck your head in and take the button turtle at this point. You just go ahead and play.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
I kind of like this. Okay, I don't want that.
Brandon Graham. In there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for that first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
Back to throw now on second and 10. First out to his left. Shreds the tackle. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
Turn. Just terrible.
Well, not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I think you've been overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
It's set up to throw. They're leading the pressure right. This will be caught at about the five. He's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. A gain of five, but not enough. Leads to a fourth and goal.
Whether you play a West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. So given three there, a good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach, but it kept the offense out of the end zone.
Now we're in the minutes. I shouldn't be dodging.
Tucker now following the made field goal set to kick it away.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the two-minute warning. On first down, Wentz. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this.
You're not even sympathy, it's still doing that. Nope. It's a language thing at the South Park. Their South Park still doing that.
Yeah. So it's Eagle football here as we
go. Or a Comedy Central report.
They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Working from again, Wentz. And the ball is knocked out. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Now Wentz on third down. Looking for Jeffrey, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 48, and he returns it into enemy territory.
Pressure's been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They send Sharp in motion right. Taylor. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
On the handoff, this is Taylor. And he gets it down to the 42. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. In motion goes the tight end. They'll look to throw here on first down. Being chased out left. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. This is 3rd and 11. Back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Pushing his way through. And he finds his target. It's Sharp. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field. And now first down following that long gain. It looks to throw. Steps away to his left. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end. But now this game is over. The story behind the history, Charles, no doubt, the number zero, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. What an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that zero on the scoreboard for them? Go along with those zeros in the time column, too.